on and about a possible motive, Vic.
Yeah, we've been working very hard at the I-Team to get these details. Jacksonville's sheriff formally identified him as 24-year-old David Katz. He is from the Baltimore area. He was a competitive Madden gamer. We found that. He went by the nickname Bread. I found a list of registered players in the Jacksonville tournament. He was on it, along with a couple dozen others. I want to show you video of him from a competition just a few years back. This was broadcast by EA Sports in partnership with the NFL. Listen specifically to what the commentators have to say about David Katz.
You are not going to see much emotion from our guy, Brett. This dude is a man David Katz keeps to himself. He's a man of business. He's not here for the experience and to go out, this, that, and the third. He's not here to make friends. He's all business. He's focused. And to even get him to open up to talk to you about anything, it's like pulling teeth, man.
JSO, the ATF, and the FBI here in Florida tell us that they are working with their law enforcement partners in Baltimore as they search that address that we told you about, linking him to South Baltimore. I'm told this is a very nice neighborhood. They have to do this very carefully, making sure that there are not any explosives or traps set. So they're going to be very meticulous, trying to talk with family members, friends, neighbors, coworkers, unraveling clues about what set him off. We have also been working to look at his background, to look for a potential criminal history. So far, we have not confirmed anything. No records yet showing any interactions with police. There's the possibility he may have been arrested in that area once before. We also know that there might have been some sort of bitter divorce case between his parents that involves withholding some medical mental health records. We just got our hands on that. Our special I-Team producer, Eric Wallace, is working on finding more details right now as we speak. And as you said, Kent and Mary, tomorrow morning, I'm going to be catching a flight to Baltimore to find out more about exactly what happened here and what is next in this investigation as the investigators try to find out exactly what caused this tragedy.